last thing that you and I should know. We say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim in everything that we do. Of all of Allah's names, Allah has many names. Al-Qahhar, Al-Wahhab, Al-Aziz, Al-Hakim. He has many names. He chose these two names for everything we begin. You're about to eat, you're about to work, you're about to get in the car, you're about to change your clothes, you're about to do anything. We say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Why is that important? That's important because we recognize something. Everything Allah is allowing us to do, everything Allah is allowing us to do is because He loves us and He cares for us. And sometimes we say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and we start the final exam in school, yeah? And then we fail that exam. It happens or no? Then you say Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. This is different dhikr, right? But in any case, You said Bismillah and you still failed the exam and you're like, hey, I said Bismillah, it didn't work. Ustaz Maman said Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Allah's love and care. Where was Allah's love and care with the exam? You have to understand one last thing about ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allah Azza wa Jal will give you His love and His care on His terms, not on your terms. And you may not always understand His terms. Somebody's in the hospital, dying of cancer, at a young age. It happens or no? And Allah is still ar-Rahman ar-Rahim to them or no? He is. But you and I cannot understand, even they may not be able to understand, in what way is Allah ar-Rahman and ar-Rahim to them. They may not know. Let me tell you one little story and I'll conclude for today. Just to understand how Allah's love and care works. Yusuf alayhi salam was a boy, taken away from his family, kidnapped, thrown in the woods, in a ditch, then sold, turned into a slave, child slavery. What a crime. If you see news today of children being sold as slaves, isn't that disgusting? Isn't that disturbing? You want to change the channel. That's what happened to Yusuf alayhi salam. Did he deserve it? No. And then he's a servant living in a house, doing a good job, doing an honest job, and he gets accused wrongly. And what happens next? He gets thrown in jail. Did he deserve being thrown in jail? No. And you're like, oh, but Allah is ar-Rahman, ar-Rahim. He should cover him in His love and His care. But he got taken away from his father. He got taken away from his family. He got thrown into jail. All of these problems happened. But you know, eventually Yusuf alayhi salam came out of jail, remember? And when he came out of jail, he interpreted a dream. And when he interpreted a dream, what did the dream mean? That the country is going to have a drought, a water problem. You guys know something about that. Yeah? The country is going to have a water problem. So all the farmland is going to dry up and die. So we have to save the food for 7 years while the water is still here. Because the next 7 years, the water will be gone. That was the interpretation of his dream. Yes or no? Because of him, if he was never in jail, the king would never have met him. And if he was never kidnapped, he would never have been in jail. And if he was never in jail, he would have never met the king. And if he never met the king, he would have never interpreted the dream. Isn't that true? And because he interpreted the dream, thousands of children for 7 years got to stay with their parents and didn't die of thirst and hunger because of Allah's plan. Because Allah didn't just show love and care to him, but sometimes Allah's love and care, maybe a little bit of your suffering creates a lot of love and care for so many other people. Subhanallah. And you know what? For every one of those children that was saved, who gets the reward? Yusuf alayhi salam. And Yusuf alayhi salam's little bit of suffering, and compared to what he's going to get, he acknowledges that Allah Azza wa Jalla is ar-Rahman, that Allah Azza wa Jalla is ar-Rahim. These are the names we call on when we start a task. Don't ever lose sight of the fact, whether things work out for you the way you want or not. One thing is always there. Allah never stopped loving. Allah never stopped protecting. Allah never stopped caring. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us from the heart a people of Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.